Monkey can play video games for 2 hours straight. Monkey can scroll through TokTik until his thumbs go numb. Monkey can binge an entire Netflix season and call it just one more episode. But ask Monkey to sit down and study for 30 minutes? Suddenly, Monkey acts like he's being tortured in the banana mines. And starting a side project? Monkey promises to work for an hour, but 5 minutes later he's already sneaking toward the fridge, pretending cleaning counts as productivity. Here's the paradox. Monkey actually knows deep down that studying, exercising, or even cleaning his room would bring long-term rewards, but Monkey still prefers the quick hits: video games, social media, TV. Why is that? Why do some monkeys out there seem motivated to tackle hard stuff every single day, while this monkey would rather nap? And the big question, is there a way to trick monkey brain into liking hard things? Part 1. Dopamine. The answer starts with a tiny chemical inside monkey's brain, dopamine. People often call dopamine the pleasure molecule, but that's not quite right. Dopamine doesn't make monkey feel pleasure. It makes monkey want. It's the craving chemical. Dopamine is the invisible banana dangling in front of monkey's face. Monkey hasn't even eaten the banana yet, but the mere thought of it gets him running. Part 2. Rat experiments. To understand how powerful dopamine is, let's look at monkey's distant cousins, the lab rats. Scientists once gave rats a lever. Every time a rat pressed the lever, electrodes zapped their brain's reward system with dopamine. The result? Rats went bananas. They pressed the lever over and over for hours, forgetting to eat, forgetting to sleep. Some literally pressed until they collapsed. Then scientists tried the opposite. They blocked dopamine in the rats' brains. The same rats suddenly became so lazy they wouldn't even get up for food or water. They weren't depressed. If food was placed directly in their mouths, they still chewed happily, but they had zero motivation to move for it. Here's the scary part. Monkey brain works the same way. Dopamine isn't about enjoying bananas. It's about motivating monkey to chase them. Part 3. Dopamine tolerance. Monkey's brain has a rule called homeostasis. It always tries to stay balanced. Too hot? Monkey sweats to cool down. Too cold? Monkey shivers to warm up. Same with dopamine. When monkey floods his brain with video games, junk food, endless scrolling, the brain adapts. It dials down dopamine receptors. Just like a drinker who needs more alcohol to feel tipsy, monkey needs bigger dopamine hits just to feel normal. It's like eating candy bananas at a 5-star buffet every single day. But soon, if someone hands monkey a plain banana, monkey sneers, "Boring. Where's the caramel drizzle?" So when monkey sits down to study, his brain compares. TokTik? Fireworks of dopamine. A textbook? Just one sad sparkler. No wonder studying feels unbearable. Monkey's brain has recalibrated. This is called dopamine tolerance, and it explains why monkey struggles so much with hard things. His brain isn't broken, just spoiled by candy bananas and no longer cares for regular ones. Part 4. Dopamine detox. Monkey decided to try something radical, a dopamine detox. Picture this. Monkey eats candy bananas at a 5-star buffet every day. After a while, a plain banana feels like an insult. But if monkey gets stranded on a deserted island, starving, suddenly that same plain banana tastes amazing. That's the logic behind detox. Take away the constant, artificial candy bananas so plain bananas, like studying or exercising, become rewarding again. There are two ways monkey can detox. Number 1. Radical detox. One whole day. No phone. No internet. No games. No junk food. Monkey sits with boredom. And when boredom hits hard, suddenly writing in a journal or reading a book feels fun. Number 2. Light detox. Once a week, monkey avoids one high dopamine behavior. Maybe no social media on Sundays. Maybe no video games on Wednesdays. It's like a mini reset. The point isn't to punish monkey. It's to reset monkey's brain, lower the tolerance, make plain bananas taste sweet again. Part 5. Reward system. Monkey knew he couldn't detox forever. Bananas are fun, after all. So he built a system. Work first. Reward after. If monkey eats the candy banana first thing, like scrolling fake book in bed, forget about studying after. Motivation gone. Instead, Monkey must flip the script. Work first, bananas later. Example: 1 hour of study earns Monkey 15 minutes of his favorite snack time, and after 8 hours of work, Monkey gets 2 hours of guilt-free fun. The key? Monkey must never reward himself before the work. The banana only comes after. Part 6: 5 Tricks to Outsmart Monkey Brain. Now that Monkey's dopamine levels are reset, Monkey can also use a few clever hacks to make work feel less painful. Number 1. Gamification. Monkey loves games, so turn work into one, make tasks into levels, earn banana points, keep a checklist. Every small victory earns Monkey a banana coin. Number 2. Start small. Monkey hates climbing mountains, but Monkey doesn't mind one small step. Trick: Monkey says, just do it for 2 minutes. Once Monkey starts, momentum kicks in, and he usually keeps going. Number 3. Instant bananas. Monkey thrives on quick rewards, so after finishing a task, give him a mini banana. One page written, eat a snack, 20 push-ups, watch TV. Small wins keep Monkey hooked. Number 4. Monkey squad. Monkey alone is lazy, but Monkey in a squad, motivated. When Monkey studies with friends or works with a group, he suddenly doesn't want to look like the slacker of the troop. Accountability works wonders. Number 5. Identity shift. Monkey acts according to identity. If Monkey says, I'm lazy, he stays lazy. If Monkey says, I'm disciplined, he starts behaving that way. Behavior follows belief. Part 7. The choice of bananas. At the end of the day, dopamine isn't the enemy. It's the reason Monkey builds, creates, and survives. The question is, where does Monkey get his dopamine? From endless scrolling and other candy banana habits? Or from growth, learning, and real progress? Monkey doesn't need to kill dopamine. Monkey just needs to crave the right bananas. Monkey doesn't naturally like hard things. But with detox, smart rewards, and a few tricks, hard things stop feeling like torture. So the next time Monkey stares at a to-do list, Monkey remembers, it's not about forcing discipline, it's about outsmarting Monkey brain. The only question is, which bananas will Monkey choose? The Monkey says thanks, like this video? Toss him a subscribe, it keeps the bananas coming.